A warm welcome to all the viewers for the course Advanced Manufacturing Technology, ME702. Myself Thiapal, Assistant Professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, JIS College of Engineering. And today I am going to give a lecture on stereolithography, which is very commonly known as SLG. Well, in my previous lecture, I have already explained you about rapid prototyping technology, and in fact, you can also say about the rapid prototyping. But today we are going to have a brief discussion about one of the technique of rapid prototyping. It is a stereolithography process. And you can see, as I have told, that with increase in demand in the today's industry, in the advanced industry, we are implementing various processes to get a desired product. So before we go for the lecture for stereolithography process, let's have a look at the content. So in the content beginning, we are going to have a look for the introduction. Then we will just go with the history. Then we will be discussing about the generative approaches. Then we are going to discuss about the realization of stereolithography. And we are going to also talk about all the process chain that involved in stereolithography. We are also going to discuss about the advantages, disadvantages that will be followed by the application. So without any further delay, let's have a look for the introduction. So stereolithography, it is another very common rapid prototyping process, and one actually that has been developed prior to the fused deposition modeling. And this is very commonly known as stereolithography process. Now the stereolithography process is based on the principle of curing, which is also known as hardening a liquid photopolymer into a specific space. A vat containing a mechanism whereby a platform can be lowered and it can be raised and is filled with a photocurable liquid, which is arsenate polymer. And the liquid is a mixture of arsenic monomers or oligomers, which is very commonly polymer intermediate, and photoinitiator. Now, when the platform is at highest position, suppose you consider A as the depth of the layer of the liquid, which is above it shallow, then you can use a laser generative and ultraviolet beam, and then it has been focused upon a selective surface area of the photopolymer. And you can see then it is moved in the some direction, that is towards the x direction or in the y direction. Now the beam cars that portion of the polymer or photopolymer, which is basically a ring shaped portion, and thereby produces a solid body. And the platform is then lowered sufficiently to cover the curved polymer with another layer of liquid polymer. And this sequence has been repeated. Next, if I talk about this particular process, then we'll be discussing when we'll be showing some figure. And you can see that it is going, this process is repeated until it reaches to a portion. Suppose you consider the level B. And thus far we have generated a cylindrical part with a constant wall thickness. And the platform is now lowered by some vertical distance. You can consider any distance as AB. Now what happened? The term stereolithography is basically used to describe the process, which comes from the fact that the movement are three-dimensional and that the process is similar to lithography, in which the image to be printed on a flat surface is ink respective and blank area are ink repellent. Also, we must consider that stereolithography can be like fixed deposit, or I mean to say fused deposit modeling, need a weaker support material. But in stereolithography, the support takes from the perforated structure. After its completion, the part is removed from the platform, bolted and cleaned ultrasonically with an alcohol bath, and the support structure is removed and the part is subjected to final curing or hardening cycle. Now, the smallest tolerance which can be achieved in stereolithography depends on the focus sharpness of the laser, and typically it is around 0.0125 millimeter, which is equivalent to 0.0005 inch. Now, oblique surfaces can also be very high quality. An interesting technique can also be used to construct two layers and then produce a transient from one layer to the next layer. The platform is lowered below the fluid level, then it has been raised above the fluid level so that the photocurable polymer forms a meshes between this layer. Now, this meshes is then further curved, or you can say hardened, it with the help of laser to form a smoother surface. Now, solid parts can be produced by applying spatial laser scanning patterns to speed production. Now, for example, by spacing scan line in stereolithography, volumes or pocket of of uncut polymer can be formed around the current cell, and when the part is later placed in a post processing oven, the pockets cut and a solid part form. Similarly, parts to be investment is also made here, and that will be drained or drainable through the honeycomb structure, which permits a significant fraction of the parts to remain uncut. And total cycle time in stereolithography range from a few hours to a day without postponing, okay, or without post processing like sanding, painting, etc. Now, depending on the capacity, the cost is also getting increased, and the cost of the liquid polymer is on the order of gallon per gallon, okay, and maximum part size it can produce is of 0.05 meter into 0.05 meter into 0.6 meter, and if I give the dimension in respect to inch, then 19 inch into 19 inch into 24 inch. So you can see the concept or the thinking of stereolithography rapid prototyping from this particular view. Now, if I go for the general introduction, then building 3 model from liquid photosensitive polymers when exposed to ultraviolet rays, and model is just built upon a platform which is situated just below the surface of the liquid epoxy or arsenate resin. A low power highly focused ultraviolet laser traces out the first layer, then it solidifies the model cross section, and an elevator incrementally lowers the platform into the liquid polymers. and this process is repeated until prototype is completed. So you can see this is basically repeating the process until you are getting the prototype or until the prototype is completed. So you have to consider so many things while implementing this particular process. Next, what we are doing is that model is placed in an ultraviolet oven for complete curing also. This curing is also known as hardening process. Now just have a look at this particular thing. The stereolithography, it basically consists of four steps. You can see this is step A, step B, step C and step D. But what is this A, B, C, D steps involvement? First of all, step A, in this particular step, three-dimensional description of part you can see here. So this is a 3D object. You can see this is x-axis, this is y-axis and this is your z-axis. This is your x, this is your y and this is your z-axis. And three-dimensional description of the part has been shown here. Now you are slicing this part. You can see so many slices are there. So in B step, what you are doing is that the part is divided into slices. And number C, suppose the material is planned. So you are now support material which has been planned. So you are basically supporting and this is your model. And D, it is none other than a set of tool direction is determined to manufacture each slice. So each portion has been sliced, you can see, to get separately. This is a 3D model. You can see so many slices are there. This is one, this is another, this is another, this is another. So these are making what? These are the slices they are performing. Now you have a look for this particular figure. This is the liquid polymer. This particular thing is your liquid polymer. And this portion, this particular portion, this is your platform. And you can see this is a mirror which is known as steerable mirror. And you can see this is the model. This is the model. How it is generated? Laser light is being used. Lenses are there which is helping you to get here. And it is getting strike at the steerable mirror and then it is getting reflected over this particular liquid polymer. And one by one, this laser light is focusing here and in the polymer, liquid polymer, you can see the model has been generated. Again, I am repeating, this is particular a platform. Here it is consisting of liquid polymers. There is a steerable mirror. This is the lens and this is this is the laser, this is your lens and with the help of this lens, the laser has been reflected over the steerable mirror and then it is getting strike and it is further getting reflected over this particular liquid polymer and you can see here the canning or hardening is occurring with the help of laser and the model has been generated. Now let's have a look for the history. So worldwide first rapid prototyping technology, it has been patented in the year 1984. Next, if you have a look for the commercialized, it has been done in the year 1988 by the 3 system or a 3D system Inc. Now what type of generative approach basically stereolithography process is using? First of all, the production of the parts basically occurs by addition of material instead of removal. Means removal means you are going for cutting operation and so on so operation, but here basically the rapid prototyping modeling like stereolithography process basically produce the parts by addition of material. No removal of material is occurring and layer by layer is built up from bottom to top, not from top to bottom. So if this is one layer, above it I am depositing another layer, above it I am depositing another layer, above it depositing another layer. So layer by layer I am just getting increased to get my desired product. Now it is very easy to manufacture for undercuts, complete structure, internal holes. All these operations can be performed with this particular process. Now how you are going to realize, or I mean to say, how you are going to realization by stereolithography? So local solidification of light sensitive liquid resin, which is known as photopolymer, using an UV ray, ultraviolet laser, and scanning of the cross section area are to be hardened with the help of laser focus. So I have already showed you in the previous diagram that laser light is passing with the help of lens, striking to the mirror and then reflected over the liquid polymer. So here you can see the same thing it has been told, that is local solidification of light sensitive liquid resin polymer has been done by help of ultraviolet laser, and scanning of the cross section area are to be hardened by focusing the laser. Now what are the process or what are the steps that had been involved in this particular process? So two things you have to remember. First of all, layer by layer curing. Curing means hardening of a liquid photopolymer by using laser, and it has to be done layer by layer. Second thing you have to do is that you have to control the laser by a scan mirror system. You have to control the laser with the help of scan mirror system. So two points you have to remember. First of all, layer by layer curing or hardening of the liquid polymer by help of laser. Second, to control the laser by using a scan mirror system. Now, if I have a look at this particular figure, then from here I am going to describe you the entire process, how this stereolithography operation basically occurs. So just have a look for this particular figure. You can see this is the platform. I have mentioned here A, B, C. This is particular the liquid surface, and you can see ultraviolet curable liquid is there, and this is the parts that has been produced. This is the part you can see. This is the part that has been manufactured. Okay, and this is a container which is known as the vat. You are using the ultraviolet light source. Okay, now just have a look. When the platform is at the highest position, this platform is at the highest position, what is the highest position? That is considered as A. And the layer of liquid above it is shallow. So all this thing is totally, this liquid is shallow. Now this laser light has been generated. Okay. Or you can say laser generating an ultraviolet beam is now focused upon the selected subjected area of the photopolymer and then moved at x and y direction. So x and y direction means this direction is determined by x and this direction is determined by y. So you can move this laser in x direction also, in y direction also. Now the platform is lowered than this to cover the polymer with another layer of liquid polymer. And you can see this process is repeated. So this process is repeated unless and until it reaches the level B. So the laser light has been focused over this liquid polymer. And you can see this is one layer form, this is another layer form, this is another layer form. This way the layer has been formed till and it reaches the level B. Okay. So if it reaches position B, from A to B, if it reaches, then it has already generated a cylindrical part. You can see this is basically a cylindrical part. This is basically a cylindrical part. It has been generated with a constant wall thickness. You see, the wall thickness is constant. Okay. Now let's move to the next portion. Now at level B, now we are talking about level B, where xy movement of the beam are wider. Now see the xy movement of the beam, it has become much more wider than A to B portion. And now we have a flange shape portion that is being produced over the previously formed part. So AB I have formed a part, now with a wider section I am forming another part over the part AB portion, that is your BC portion. And you can see after the proper thickness of the liquid has been carved or hardened, the process is repeated and it is producing another cylindrical section between level B and C. Just you note one thing, that is the surrounding liquid polymer is still fluid because it has not been exposed to the ultraviolet beam, and that the part has been produced from bottom up to the individual slice. The unused portion of the liquid polymer can be used again to make another part or another prototype. So the liquid can be reusable. Note that the term stereolithography, as used to describe this process, comes from the fact that the movement are three-dimensional and that the process is similar to stereolithography, in which the image to be printed on a flat surface is in respective and blank area ink repellent. Also you have to note that stereolithography can be like fused deposition modeling, but in fused deposition modeling need a weaker support material, but in stereolithography this support takes from the form of perforated structure itself. After its completion, the part is removed from the platform. It has been bolted and it has been cleaned ultrasonically and with an alcoholic bath. Then the support structure is removed and the part is subjected to a final curing cycle also, or you can say final hardening cycle. So from this particular process, it is very clear to all of you how this operation basically occurs. Again, if I summarize one thing, then I must say a vat is there which containing a liquid. This is the platform over which the material has to be done. The lowest part I am considering as the A, ultraviolet laser beam has been focused here over the liquid, and the deposition of, or I mean to say the curing or hardening of the liquid is occurring layer by layer from A to B at a constant. A cylindrical portion has been generated from B to C, much more wider portion I have made, and it has been getting this form shape. And the most important thing is that the liquid which is subjected to ultraviolet laser beam, that oligates solidify. Others liquid, they are not getting any time or any way it is getting affected. So later what you can do is that you can use this particular polymer to form another part also or another prototype model also. So clear, I think, from this particular view. Now you have a look for the schematic layout of the stereolithography. You can see this is the Z drive, there is a platform, you are using a support, this is photopolymer that has been used, the level sensor is there to give the level of the material, you are using a flat field lens, and this is the part that has been generated. So laser, from the source of laser, it is getting emitted, the beam is getting emitted, shutter, modulator is there, surface mirror are there which are using to reflect, then expansion of the optics is occurring, a scanner is there, there is a lens which is helping it to get focus over this particular polymer, photopolymer. So what are the main component? Exposure system, vat with liquid photopolymer, table with Z drive. So what are the process steps that have been involved in this particular process? It has been lowering of the table by the thickness of one layer, application and leveling of the liquid resin, scanning with laser, again lowering of the table. So these are the basic four steps that are involved while carrying out the stereolithography processes. Just have a look. The process step, this laser, it is getting here focused. Now supports, what are the supports that is required, that is needed for a manufacture of undercut? Build up with part similarities to be just like honeybee structure. So this thing you have to remember. Now process chain of stereolithography. First you are using CAD model, then you are doing triangulation, then you are giving support, and then you are doing slicing. So CAD modeling involves 3D CAD data that must be available. Triangulation means conversion of STL data, representation of surface by a small triangle, orientation of geometry to the machine's workpiece. Now what are the supports? Generation of support data, and this will help to build up together with the parts, and later honeybee structure is required for easy removal also. Next we are talking about slicing. Slicing means what? Slicing of the part geometry and support data into a layer. So these particular four process has to be remembered: CAD modeling, triangulation, supports and slicing. Now process chain of this particular stereolithography process. First is process setup, which includes data transfer to machine, setting up of the job, start building up the process. If I go for production, then you can see, there you can see the image that is occurring. It is nothing but layer by layer exposure of geometry. And after performing this operation, we are going for some other post processing, that is cleaning and finishing. What you have to do is that take out the part from the liquid polymer, clean of the excess resin, removal of the supports is also required, and surface finish, if it is required according to your requirement, then kindly provide it. Either it is not required. And what are the post curing or the post hardening process? That is, if you want to increase the strength of the product much more, then go for final hardening under the ultraviolet light. What are the materials that we are supporting for this particular process? It is only one photopolymer of different quality that is available. First of all, it has to be temperature proof. Second, the material photopolymer must be flexible to be used. And third, it should be transparent. Now you see various materials have been told here. What are the material? You can see that is Acura 25, Acura 55, Acura 60, Acura Bluestone. What are the appearance? It can be white, it is clear, it is opaque blue. Now what is the penetration depth? This can be 4.2 miles, it can be 5.2 miles, it is 6.3 miles and this is 4.1 miles. Critical exposure, it is 10.5 megajoule per centimeter square, 7.4 megajoule per centimeter square, 7.6 megajoule per centimeter square and this is 6.9 megajoule per centimeter square. What are the tensile strength? 38 megapascal, 63 to 68 megapascal, 58 to 68 megapascal and this is 66 to 68 megapascal. What is the elongation at break? 13 to 20%, 5 to 8%, 5 to 13% and 1.4 to 2.4%. Now we are looking for the advantages. Obviously, high part complexity is used, high accuracy product you are achieving, and it supports the structure that is required. So these are the three advantages of this particular process. So what are the disadvantages? The part size that can be produced is of 250 into 250 into 250 millimeter cube to 1000 into 800 into 500 millimeter cube. The accuracy of the job that has been obtained by rapid prototyping process through stereolithography process, it is of 0.05 millimeter. But the facility cost is too high. These are the application you can see here, stereolithography product. So, thank you all of you for listening this particular process about stereolithography, which is one of the process of rapid prototyping. So, if you have liked the video, then please subscribe the channel, like the video and stay connected so that in other lecture we are going to discuss about various other rapid prototyping techniques too. Thank you all of you.